It was like summer of 1994. I'm in New York City, and I'm filming every day. You know, basically, I'm going to the Brooklyn Banks. I'm, you know, skating Midtown. You know, skating at night, skating in the day. You know, whatever. Got all this footage together that summer and sent it to 4-1-1. And I remember sending it off, and there's like 14 tapes. You know what I mean? So it's like 14 hours of footage. Sent that to 4-1-1. Wait a week. You know, like fuck, a week. Do you think the tapes got there? It's been a week. Call up and get Josh. And I was like, yeah, I sent you guys a bunch of tapes and a bunch of stuff. He's like, oh yeah, no, we got it. You know, like we got it. And I'm like, oh cool, man. Did you see this trick? Like, you know what I mean? He's like, oh yeah, that was cool, man. It's kind of dark though. You know what I mean? Like, I was getting kind of bummed as I was talking to him because I'd filmed all these things that I thought were like really rad tricks. And then I was like, oh, well, what about you know, Kim Cardona? He did a nollie inward heel flip over the Brooklyn Banks wall. You know, did you see that? And Josh was like, oh yeah, no, we saw it. It's gonna be an opener. And I was like, what? And he's like, yeah, it's gonna be an opener in the next issue. And I was just like, you know, like floored. I mean, to actually get something, an opener in actual 4-1-1 through 4-1-1, that was insane. See where the guy is with the baby? That stop there, let me focus, and then just go down there. Just push. If you want to do some flat ground, you can. If you want to just push, you can. Okay. It's kind of crazy. You're in the moment and you're in a place. You don't notice like murals on the street. You don't notice like the different looking cars, the different looking buses, or like just stop signs and shit like that. And then later on, you're in front of the computer in another country and you're watching the footage. You're like, damn, dude, that looks so sick. It's not even the trick only. It could be all kinds of different little things like the texture of the sidewalk or anything, dude, you know? It's cool. I vividly remember this, being in the backseat of the car, and then we drove past a spot. I guess it was the Fuji building. Look over, there's like a set of stairs, and it's kind of like a little pit. And I just see like dudes like ollieing into it. You know what I mean? It's probably like four stairs or something. And it was like a magical moment. You know what I mean? Like that like fucking was like, wow, man, skateboarding, like that's super cool. Like I want to do that. I would probably say like in 1990, one of my homies in the crew, you know, his dad had a video camera. And we were filming stuff, but nobody, it wasn't premeditated. You know, like nobody was like, oh, I want to do this trick. Fast forward a little bit. So me and my friend Jürgen, you know, like my best friend, he ended up going to school at Rutgers. And then we were like, let's do a zine, you know what I mean? So we call it Action Figure. And basically I did not know anything about photography at all. So Jürgen shot some photos and like, you know, I borrowed a video camera and I'd like film tricks and we'd make video grab sequences. And then that's how we made the zine. Around that same time, 4-1-1 started. So it was like, you know, I was like, oh wow, these guys are doing like, you know, video magazine. Part of 4-1-1 was like, you know, like there was like an address at the end and there's like, it was like, you know, contributors welcome. I would film with like a lot of zoo guys. Filming was like, you know, I'd go to the Banks every day. There'd be dudes there and like, you'd be like, you want to film something? And it wasn't really premeditated. 4-1-1, I guess issue 6 came out and there was a Zoo York Industry and a bunch of my tricks were in there. And I remember tripping, just like, whoa, like, that was a big milestone just to have stuff in a Zoo York Industry. Like that was an honor and like an accomplishment. I started to kind of think of like, fuck man, I want to travel. I want to go places. And my dad had just moved to San Francisco. I mean, long story short, went to SF in the winter of 94 and just fucking skated. Skated with a bunch of people, filmed with a bunch of people, randomly met people on the street, made some connections, met Joe Brook.
I think with anything with Anthony, he's put skateboarding before anything in his life. Like when I first met him, he was filming for 4-1-1, and he probably just started something for 4-1-1, and I think he was filming Gershon Mosley. It was Gershon downtown for sure at the Pine Street Bump, and like I was like, who is this fucking guy? Like he was just, you know what I mean? Like so dedicated from day one, and like his vision is so big, and like he just wants to make things happen, and like it's cool, like he just has fun, you know.
Bobby Puglio to me was like the dude that I filmed with and I skated with, you know, that was like the best skater in New York. Bobby Puglio's Wheels of Fortune was one of the first things that I did for 411, like a first article, and that was skating and filming with Bobby probably four times. Chris and Josh were like hyped on what I was doing and what I was contributing, and they, you know, I mean, Chris offered basically to put me on a retainer to get paid for 411, you know, even if it was a retainer, even if it was 500 or 750 bucks, that was amazing, you know what I mean? I mean, I felt like I made it. I remember it was like probably 97 that 411 released a Europe video, and Dan Wolf had gone to Europe and covered all the Europe contests, and like they made a video, and that blew my mind, you know. And I was like, fuck, dude, Europe, dude, like shit was like Mars, you know what I mean? Like, I want to go next year, you know, I want to do this. Chris and, you know, Josh opened the door. They're like, you know, like, tell us what you want to do, tell us what you want to work on, you know what I mean? And I'd just be like, fuck, dude, there's a contest or there's a thing, so that's a way to get somewhere. And then, you know, like my homie lives there, and like, so I'll work on a part with him. So it's like, I could travel somewhere and for a contest for a weekend, but I'll try to stay for 2 weeks and to film street skating too, you know what I mean? And it was just like, nobody wanted to film a contest, that shit sucks. But if it was a way to go to England for 2 weeks, or a way to get to Prague, or a way to go somewhere and discover like Barcelona, then that was what I would do, man. Going back to my best friend in high school, I started skating with Jurgen. One day he saw this offer, Malaysian Airlines, you know what I mean? And it was like a Malaysian Airlines, and it was like 750 bucks, and you can go to any or and all of the cities that Malaysian Airlines flew to. And so like, talked to a bunch of my homies, and like I talked to Joe Brooke, talked to like Rob G, talked to fucking Kenny Reed, talked to 411. It's like, hey, would you be down to pay? It's 750 bucks. You can go to all these places. We'll pick 9 cities. We'll do 9 cities in 30 days. It'll be a trip. It'll be for 411. And you know, I remember Ortiz being like, you know, like, all right, sounds good. You know, yeah, sounds crazy. Yeah, why not? You know, I used to film with Kenny Reed a lot. You know, that's my homie. And, you know, I took him on his first trip out of the country, and, you know, Kenny Reed became like the traveler, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's rad, you know, like, you know, you're with people like Rob G, and like, you know, we just wanted to travel. We wanted to see places, and that became videos like around the world, or that became like, you know, Kenny went on to go to fucking countries and skate places that I'd never even heard of. Every opportunity I had in skateboarding really came from 411, came from Chris Ortiz and Josh Freeberg. Beyond that, my dude, the dude I filmed with a lot in New York and who kind of made the trip to California and got sponsored, that's Frank Gerwer. You know, he rode for the firm. The firm was like a really small company, and it was more than just skateboarding to me. It was like a little bit of a family. Lance was like a hero to me as a kid. I filmed for 411, and Lance always did the intro for 411. So like, he wanted to really make a video. And so it was a lot of, you know, filming for 411 and kind of always chipping away at a video. And it was cool. It was like 411 was like my day job, and then the firm was like my side job. The team was getting more and more legit. And then Bob Berrics quit Antihero to ride for the firm. And that was huge. That was insane. And then, you know, I went to Europe 99 and I filmed the contest, and there was this kid from Brazil, Rodrigo TX. You know, I met him on the course, and he's like this little kid, and he was like ripping, like doing crazy tricks. And I remember, like, you know, he popped up on the platform, and I was like, man, that was super sick. You know, my name's Anthony, you know, I filmed 411, like we should film some stuff. And I remember like him, he would just like look up at me, he's like, just smiled and like, you know, like nodded his head. He didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. He couldn't speak one word of English. And, you know, he went on to win Prague, the last contest of that summer. Lance was like, yeah, like, you know, Rodrigo's gonna ride for the firm. And I was like, oh, sick. You know, I was always filming with Javier Sarmiento through the Europe contest and through Powell. The same thing, going traveling around Europe. Like, I met this little kid, Uyghur, and he was just super rad, man. I was like, skated super fast, like, yeah, the illest flick, and like did tricks that nobody really did, you know what I mean? Since like the firm was kind of the family, like all my favorite skaters, all the dudes that I like really liked, and all the dudes that I really kind of like, dudes who weren't sponsored or like kind of fell through the cracks, like I always wanted to get them on the firm. Like I said, like 411 was like the day job, and like I put a lot of energy into trying to help the firm and make a video, which ended up being Can't Stop.
audiência pra televisão. Eu não sou audiência para solidão.